A top story today, and President Uhuru Kenyatta is at this hour meeting leaders from Mount Kenya in Sagana State Lodge. It has been months of disquiet in the region, with leaders decrying insufficient development. This even as the rift within the ruling Jubilee Party has seen some leaders drawn from central Kenya openly defy the head of state on heightening the political temperatures over the 2022 general election. Today's meeting comes ahead of the highly anticipated BBI report that has already seen battle lines drawn even before its release. And we're now joined by our senior political reporter, Duncan Hayemba, who is joining me live in studio. Hayemba, it's great to see you. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank
Straight
you.
On to what the agenda for today's meeting could be.
It's I spoke to the State House spokesperson, Kanze Dena, in the morning, and she confirmed the meeting and, of course, said that it is purely a closed-door meeting. However, what I've been able to gather a few minutes ago is that the agenda, largely to those who are privy to what I've seen the program, there are two issues that will be discussed at length. One is development, and, of course, secondly, it will be the hot politics within the president's backyard or stronghold, that is the central region. So those are the issues that we do understand, but of course maybe there are other matters that will crop up under the AOB if time allows. However, it is important to note that what we suspect part of development. Remember, there was a time the group calling itself Mount Kenya Caucus, they'd accused the president that in as much as they voted him the last man, a part of the central region, the central part of the country was lagging behind in terms of development, and they were seeing the president going big in other areas in terms of launching the projects. So what happened, there was that famous Lamada team that was constituted to come up with the development agenda for the region. And when that meeting started, you know, what became, cropped out of that, there were allegations of schemes to assassinate the DP and all that. But there are cabinet secretaries that were given specific mandate after the president responded to their cries and told them that they have to meet the CSS. Then they give sort of an agenda or their wish list, which they need to present to the president. And therefore, that is how the Lamada meeting started before it turned political again. So the three CSS that we do understand, people who will speak, what I've reliably been informed, we'll have the Lamada CSS, Professor Margaret Kobia. We'll have Peter Munya. We'll have Joe Musheru. They will be, I think, briefing the president on the status of what came of the wish list that members had submitted before the Lamada Hotel meetings were scattered after claims of DP's assassination came up. So that is what we do understand. And it's important to note that we do understand the persons that will speak in this particular meeting. We'll have the host governor, Mutahi Kahiga of Nyeri. And then we'll have Governor Kiraitu Murungi from Nyeri and Kirinyaga's Anne Waiganjo. So those are the three that will speak in terms of governors. And then the senators, the host senator, Ephraim Kirinyaga Maina, will speak in his capacity as the host. And then his Embu counterpart, Njeru Ndwiga, will also speak. Members of parliament, only two, will speak if the plan remains. This is a purely a president's meeting, and therefore he knows why maybe those are the persons that have been picked. Therefore, Mathira Member of Parliament Rigathi Gachagua will talk, as well as Nyeri Town MP Wambugu Gunjiri. So those are the confirmed names that they'll have an opportunity to speak. However, there are leaders, because we know that governors have been invited, members of parliament, members of county assemblies, and other opinion leaders, women representatives, the youth, the church. Therefore, there are others that might be given an opportunity, but so far, those are the seven individuals that we do understand on the program actually will be talking. So in terms of the agenda, that is what we do expect.
You've largely told us who will be present, but interestingly enough, Hayemba, this comes after the dramatic cancellation by the presidency of the, you know, the tour to Muranga on Sunday, and now today, Friday, he is meeting these leaders in Nyeri. What do we get from that?
We, of course, we've said the agenda there too. Yes. We have development and politics. So probably the perceived rift or the tussle within the presidency is what will largely be addressed. More so that dramatic cancellation at the 11th hour on Sunday, the twin events. The deputy president had to cancel the two events that he was supposed to do in the same county, and then the president as well at the SEK in Muranga. And therefore, of course, it left many maybe embarrassed, maybe the organizers, on how such high-profile events were dramatically cancelled at the last minute. So those are some of the issues that maybe will feature on. And remember, as we talked earlier, there's a time again the president sort of stormed an event that had been organized at Kasarani for the Akorino Church, in which the DP was the chief guest. Well, the DP was yet to arrive. The president went there, and that's when he castigated members within his party from his backyard who were concentrating more on succession politics at the expense of development. Therefore, maybe those are some of the matters that will come at play when they go political. And maybe largely the BBI that many are saying, the rival. Remember, Naivasha Member of Parliament Jane Kihara has termed the handshake or the BBI as nonsense. And therefore, they've rubbished it. And maybe that is the reason why the president might read an riot act to them, because now everybody's running out of patience. Why is it that the BBI task force report is not being made public? So maybe that could be a matter that we'll be expecting.
Sure. And of course, there's also the rift, you know, the Kieleweke and the Tanga Tanga factions. But that's all the time we had, Hayemba. Thank you so much for joining me. Our senior political reporter there, Duncan Hayemba, telling us, you know, among other things, what we expect, what we speculate as the agenda for today's meeting at the Sagana State Lodge in Nyeri, where President Uhuru Kenyatta is currently meeting Mount Kenya leaders. You know, he mentioned matters development, matters central region politics.